Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss settlement of pile groups. The settlement of a pile group is due to elastic shortening of piles and due to the settlement of the soil which support the piles. It is assumed that the pile group acts as a single large deep foundation such as fire or a mat foundation. The total load is assumed to act at a depth equal to 2/3 of the pile length in case of frictional piles, and in case of end bearing piles, the total load is assumed to act at the pile tips. So here in this figure we can see friction pile, and the total load is acting at a depth of 2/3 of the total depth of the pile. Here in this figure we can see end bearing piles, and the total load is acting at the tip, means at the bottom of the pile. In case of combined action, the frictional component is assumed to act at 2/3 depth and the bearing component act at the tip. For the determination of the settlements, the compression characteristics of the soil are required. For clay soil, the characteristics are determined from a laboratory test on the undisturbed sample. For cohesionless soils, the characteristics are obtained from the empirical correlations developed from the in-situ penetration test. So let us first discuss the characteristics determination for cohesionless soils, which are determined from the laboratory test which are conducted on undisturbed sample. The first method is the Skempton method. The settlement of the pile group is estimated from the settlement of a single pile as determined in the pile load test. The settlement of the group is generally very large because the pressure bulb for the group is much deeper than that of the single pile. Skempton published curves relating to the settlement of the pile group SG for a given total foundation with to that of a single pile S0. The curve can be used for the both driven and bore piles. So this is the curve given by the Skempton. X-axis gives the width of the foundation and y-axis indicates the ratio SG by SO. So if we know the width of the foundation, we can get the ratio of SG upon SO. So after putting the value of SG in this ratio, we will get the value of SO from this chart. The second method for the determination of the settlement characteristic of cohesionless soil is Meyerhoff method. Meyerhoff suggested the following empirical relation for this elastic settlement of a pile group in sands and gravels. SG is equal to 9.4 Q under root BGI divided by N, where SG is settlement of group in mm. Q is the load intensity and it is given as Qg divided by Ag. Bg is equal to width of the group. I is the influence factor, which is equal to 1 minus D divided by 8Bg, and it should be less than or equal to 0.5. D is the length of the pile. N is the corrected standard penetration number within the seat of settlement, and it is approximately equal to Bg below the tip. If static cone results are available, the settlement of the group can be obtained from the relation Sg is equal to QBgI divided by 2QC, where QC is the average penetration resistance within the seat of the settlement. Now let us discuss the settlement characteristics of clay soil. The consolidation settlement of a pile group in a clay can be determined using consolidation test. Generally, a 2:1 load distribution is assumed from the level at which the load acts. Sometimes the load is assumed to spread outwards from the edge of the block at an angle 30 degree to the vertical. For 2:1 distribution, the stresses increases at the middle of each layer is calculated as Qi is equal to Qg divided by Bg plus Zi into Ls plus Zi, where Zi is the distance from the level of the application of the load to the middle of the clay layer. The settlement of each layer caused by the increased stress is given by delta Si equal to delta Ei plus 1 plus E naught I into Hi, where delta Ei is the change of void ratio caused by stress increase. E naught I is the initial void ratio of the layer I. Hi is the thickness of the layer I. Alternatively, delta Si is equal to Cc into Hi divided by 1 plus E naught I into log sigma naught bar plus delta sigma I bar sigma I divided by sigma naught bar. The total consolidation settlement is equal to the sum of the settlement of all layers. That means Sg is equal to summation of delta S of all I layers. Thank you.